Ed Janum, with Republicans holding a strong majority in both the House and in the Senate, it's really no surprise that the governor stressed a message of bipartisanship in his inaugural address. But moving forward, it appears there will still be a clear and sharp difference of opinion. Now, the governor spent about 45 minutes addressing lawmakers, and while he spent a lot of that time talking about the fiscal challenges facing the state, i.e. the budget, it appears he didn't provide the answers that Republicans were looking for.
The oath of office complete, the governor turned his attention to the address, acknowledging the monster challenge of the session, a budget deficit that Republicans estimate is as high as $800 million.
To balance the budget, we must continue assessing how we provide every state government service and decide what services we should continue providing. But our reductions should not come at the expense of our most vulnerable citizens.
Before a general court with a strong Republican majority, the governor also announced plans for several initiatives, an amendment to settle the education funding issue, as well as a revolving loan fund for infrastructure improvements.
But almost everything we discuss comes back to the most important policy statement we can make as a state, our budget.
Flanked by the Republican Speaker of the House and Republican Senate President, the governor received polite applause during the address, but following it, both criticized Lynch for not offering concrete plans.
How are we going to work with a governor that doesn't put his proposals on the table? We don't hear them when he's not making speeches. We don't hear them when he is making speeches. We need more from this governor.
We're concerned that it wasn't until halfway through the speech the governor even hinted that we're facing a huge financial crisis within the state. And after proposing a whole bunch of new programs, he mentions, oh, we might have a budget problem, and then moves on to proposing new programs.
It's no surprise the governor didn't exactly receive a ringing endorsement from Republican leaders. But now as lawmakers ready to get down to business, he reminded them that New Hampshire has a lot to be proud of.
As we move forward, we must not abandon the very policies that have made us the envy of the nation.
And the governor also received loud applause when he talked about doubling the R&D tax credit and expanding broadband, affordable broadband, statewide. But if Republicans are looking for specifics on the governor's budget plan, they're going to have to wait a little while. The budget address is scheduled to take place on February 15th. All right, one of the more moving moments of the governor's inaugural address came when he acknowledged and commended the leaders of New Hampshire's National Guard Charlie Company. It was a loud and long-standing ovation for them and the entire company as well. Of course, just a few weeks ago, they brought home all of the 70 of the soldiers under their command from the war zone in Afghanistan. And today, they were honored for a job well done. And certainly, all that gratitude is well deserved. And with that, we are going to wrap up our coverage of Governor John Lynch's fourth inauguration here in Concord. Live from the State House, I'm Josh McKelvin, WMUR News 9.